Good morning students, myself Ravina. Today we learn about stereochemistry of carbon compounds, unit 5 in semester. Now we discuss about DL configuration. This is very familiar and important topic in your stereochemistry of carbon compounds. Okay, very important question in your public examinations, 15 marks question, DL configuration and RS configuration. Both questions, they coming back 15 marks question. Okay, let us see what is DL configuration. There are the some of the sequence rules and what are these rules. If you rotate the plane polarizer light, then we get what happened here. Okay, first, this method was proposed by Fisher and a scientist. Ideal configuration method proposed cheyadam jarigindi. Again, it is also said to be relative configuration method. Okay, in this, some of the sequence rules provided by Fisher. What are these rules? Let us see. First one, according to this rule, all the carbon atoms of the compound are represented along the vertical line. Here, this is the vertical line and this is the horizontal line. All the carbon atoms are represented along the vertical line. Okay, this one is the first rule. Next, second rule. A chiral carbon is represented at the cross section of vertical line and horizontal line. Actually, what is chiral carbon? Let us see what is chiral carbon. A carbon which having different functional groups, then we call it as a chiral carbon. Okay, the carbon which having different functional groups, then we call it as a chiral carbon. But in the second rule, what we have say, a chiral carbon is represented at cross section of vertical line and horizontal line, is nothing but a carbon is placed at vertical line and horizontal line. This is the chiral carbon. Okay, let us see third rule. More oxidized functional group is placed at top of the vertical line. And lesser oxidized functional group. Is placed at bottom of the functional group. Are you got it my point? More oxidized functional group is placed at top of the vertical line. Here, top of the vertical line. Okay? Here, less oxidized functional group is placed at the bottom of the vertical line. Got it, students? Again, I will explain you DL configuration. This method was proposed by Fisher. It is also said to be Reto configuration method. Some of the sequence rules provided, if you take a carbon compound project on a plain paper, we follow some of the sequence rules. Oka carbon compound gaani plain paper meda manam project cheyalante konni sequence rules anevi manam follow. According to this rule, all the carbon atoms of the compound are represented along the vertical line. Carbon atoms anni kuda vertical line meda represent cheyali. A carbon chiral carbon is represented at cross section of vertical line and horizontal line. Chiral carbon. Actually, chiral carbon ante enti? Carbon which having different functional groups, then we call it as a chiral carbon. Here this is a vertical line and this is a horizontal line. Chiral carbon is placed at the middle of the two lines. This is known as chiral carbon. Third one, more oxidized functional group is placed at the top of the vertical line. ఈ వెర్టికల్ లైన్ మీద మోర్ ఆక్సిడైజ్డ్ ఫంక్షనల్ గ్రూప్ అనేది ప్లేస్ చేస్తాం. అండ్ ఆక్సిడైజ్డ్ ఫంక్షనల్ గ్రూప్ ఈస్ ప్లేస్డ్ అట్ బాటమ్ ఆఫ్ ద వెర్టికల్ లైన్. లెస్సర్ ఫంక్షనల్ గ్రూప్ ఈస్ ఆక్సిడైజ్డ్ ఫంక్షనల్ గ్రూప్ ఈస్ ప్లేస్డ్ అట్ ద బాటమ్ ఆఫ్ ద వెర్టికల్ లైన్. నౌ ఫోర్త్ సీక్వెన్స్ రూప్. The groups which are attached, the groups which are attached to the vertical line, we understood that vertical line we understood behind the plane of the paper. Okay. The groups which are attached to the vertical line or behind the plane of the paper, that means which are far away from the observer. Far away from the observer, that means observer is nothing but I. Meeru chusetappudu vertical line lo unna functional groups anni kuda far away koncham dooranga kanipistu untundi. Whereas fifth one, the groups which are attached to the horizontal line, they are understood nearer to the observer. ఏవైతే గ్రూప్స్ అనేవి హారిజంటల్ లైన్ మీద ఉన్నాయో మనకి క్లియర్గా అబ్జర్వ్ చేస్తాము అని చెప్పగలం అబ్జర్వర్. ఓకే, సిక్స్త్ పాయింట్, సిక్స్త్ సీక్వెన్స్ రూల్. ఆఫ్టర్ అబౌ దీస్ అరేంజ్మెంట్స్ ఇఫ్ యూ లుకింగ్ the organic molecule on a paper, then relatively more electronegative atom or group is placed towards right side. Are you able to understand my words? Sixth sequence rules is nothing but organic molecule on a paper, then relatively more electronegative atom or group is placed at towards right side, then it is designated as D-isomer. okay. Seventh one, if more electronegative atom or group is placed left hand side, then it is called as L isomer. Okay, more electronegative atom which is placed at right hand side, then it is called a D isomer. If more electronegative atom placed at left hand side, then we call it as a L isomer. Okay, most electronegative atom placed at a left hand side, then it call it as a L isomer. Let us see example number 1, glyceraldehyde. What is the formula for glyceraldehyde? CH bond CHO bond OH bond CH2OH. This is the chiral carbon. Why? Because here having 4 different functional groups, then we call it as a chiral carbon. This is chiral carbon. Okay, this is the structure of glyceraldehyde. We apply all these sequence rules. Here the chiral carbon is placed between two vertical line, horizontal line and vertical line. The most electronegative atom is placed at the right hand side, then we call it as a D glyceraldehyde. Here most oxidizing functional group is placed at the top of the vertical plane and less oxidized functional group is placed at the bottom of the vertical line. Are you able to understand my words? First rule is nothing but, what is the first rule? Carbon atoms of the compound is placed at the vertical, first carbon, second carbon and third carbon. Next, second rule, chiral carbon is placed at the cross section of vertical line and horizontal line. This is the second rule. Third rule is nothing but, more oxidized functional group is placed at the top of the functional group, vertical line, and the less oxidized functional group is placed at the bottom of the functional group. Next, organic molecule on a plane of paper, relatively more electronegative atom is placed at the right hand side, then we call it as a D-glyceraldehyde. If more electronegative atom is placed at left hand side, then we call it as a D-glyceraldehyde. Are you understand, students? If you have any doubts, please ask me. Let us see another example to lactic acid. Formula for lactic acid, CH3 bond CH bond OH bond COOH. This is the chiral carbon. Why? Because the carbon containing 4 different functional groups, then we call it as a chiral carbon. Let us see COOH, OH, H, CH3. Okay, first carbon, second carbon, third carbon, all the carbon atoms are arranged at the vertical line. Okay, chiral carbon is placed between vertical line and horizontal line. This is the chiral carbon. Next one, more oxidizing functional group is placed at the top of the vertical line and less oxidized functional group is placed at the bottom of the functional group. Next one, more electronegative atom is placed at the right hand side, then we call it as a D-lactic acid. Another one, COOH, bond C, bond OH, bond H. More electronegative atom is placed at the left hand side, then we call it as a L-lactic acid. Okay students, this is very very important topic in your stereochemistry, no doubt at all. This is very important question in your public examination. Thank you.